Hey, how's it going? This is Ikru Fei from Spectra Audio, and I'm here today to talk about the new updates for ACDGEN Max for Live and AU/VST3 editions. ACDGEN is an advanced pattern generator that lets you generate MIDI patterns algorithmically and modify them in real time. The 10 algorithms available in ACDGEN let you create different kinds of patterns, such as bass lines and melodies. With ACDGEN, you can create new patterns using the Generate button, modify them in real time, and then export them directly into your DAW's timeline. ACDGEN is available both as a Max for Live device, as well as audio unit and VST3 plugins, so it can be used in different DAWs and systems. The new 2.2 update for the Max for Live edition and the 1.2 update for the AU/VST3 edition are now both available, and they include new features that will let users explore ACDGEN's pattern generation like never before. So let's check them out. The biggest change in these new updates is that ACDGEN can now store all generated patterns, along with their settings and per instance. This means that you can now generate multiple patterns, and ACDGEN will store all of them internally, letting you later go through them and organize them according to your own needs. If you're using ACDGEN in the studio, you can use this to keep different patterns for different parts of your song. If you're using ACDGEN live, you can use this to work on some patterns in advance and then have them ready to use during your live performances. Using the Pattern Selector, I can scroll through all my previously generated patterns and maybe delete the ones I don't like. I can also give each pattern a unique name, like Intro, Section 1, or so on. If you're using more than one instance of ACDGEN in your project, each instance will keep its own list of generated patterns, so you can use them for different purposes. Each generated pattern contains three variations and all settings related to the pattern, such as transpose, length, and density. Notice that pattern management in ACDGEN is very simple. ACDGEN automatically loads the pattern in real time, and I can also do this while ACDGEN is playing. So like I said before, each pattern can store three different variations, a bass sequence, and two additional variations generated from it. For these new updates, we've added two new buttons, New and Favorite. The Favorite button, labeled FAV, lets you mark variations as favorites. For now, this is mostly for organizational purposes. The new button replaces the old Variate button, and it will let you regenerate the active variation based on the first variation and the variation amount tweak. We've also updated the MIDI clip export functionality for both Max for Live and AU/VST3 editions. Exported MIDI clips now include the name of the pattern, variation number, and proper swing offsets. The Max for Live edition export feature can now export directly to the arrangement timeline. ACDGEN will export the clip to the clip list if you're in session view, or to the current timeline position if you're in the arrangement view. It will also automatically assign different colors for each pattern. so we can combine these updates to the MIDI clip export with the new pattern selector to quickly manage all our generated patterns and arrange them in a song directly in our DAW's timeline. These new updates also include many bug fixes, improvements to ACDGEN's algorithm and accent distribution, new chromatic scale, new options for MIDI mapping, improved support for the Ableton push, and more. So if you'd like to know more about ACDGEN, Max4Life, or AU/VST3 editions, check out spectroaudio.com/ACDGEN. Until next time, and as always, thanks for watching.